you know, growing up here in the coastal area, I'm 73, and I've seen whole hammock islands, or marsh hammocks, disappear, and you see many, many acres of dead forests that are being flooded by rising sea level. One thing, people move, you know, anywhere around here. You can see houses behind us. They're building up right to the edge. And when I was a kid, riverfront property was a big deal. No one really wanted marshfront property. But now, marshfront property is valuable, and so a lot of the marsh edge habitat is being developed. But they'll clear the lot, they'll put in sod. And sod, just to give you an example, there's a turtle, a wonderful turtle that lives in the salt marsh called the Diamondback Terrapin. They're the only turtle that spends his whole life in the salt marshes. And they come ashore to nest, but they can't dig through turf. I mean, you put in sod, and they can't. Now, places where they used to nest, they can't nest anymore. So if you put in a whole subdivision, wall-to-wall yards, they all have sod, then suddenly that turtle has nowhere to nest. You know, if sea level rises, it's got to go somewhere. So it normally would move over the land, but if you have a house there, you know, people are trying to build barriers against rising sea level. And the sea, if it continues at the rate it is now, will win. I mean, there's no question about that.
We're lucky in Georgia to have some of the most extensive salt marshes on the coast of the United States. Around 400,000 acres of salt marsh in Georgia, and that comprises about one-third of the salt marsh on the east coast of the United States. And marshes provide so many services for people. First of all, they provide a nursery for fish and shellfish. A lot of fish and shellfish spend all or part of their life up in the marsh, hiding from predators and getting bigger so that they can survive. Secondly, marshes, I like to say, are the first line of defense for coastal communities to protect from storms. They provide a physical barrier that dissipates tidal energy. Some of the most damage that happens to coastal communities during a hurricane is from storm surge. And so marshes act as a barrier to disperse that energy from the tides. They collect sediment that also helps to protect the coast from storms. Lastly, marshes are what I call the kidneys of the coast. They act to absorb pollutants as water flows from the land surface to coastal oceans, drawing up the excess nutrients and other pollutants to prevent damage to ecosystems as that happens. There are a number of threats to the health of salt marshes in Georgia. One of the main ones, which is not just Georgia, but all over the world really, is habitat destruction and development. Another is dams and channelizations. Armoring is another threat. That is, many coastal communities are building bulkheads along the coast. That prevents marshes from naturally migrating with sea level rise. Pollution also will weaken the salt marsh and its ability to respond to climate change. Two relatively simple solutions that we are enacting here in Georgia. For one, conserving marshes, okay? We know that marshes require the ability to migrate inland to respond to climate change. So just setting aside land for that retreat, as we call it, or that migration, is one way to help the marshes to be sure that they respond. Really helping the marsh help itself. If we leave the marsh in place and conserve it, it will be able to thrive. Research shows that the marsh will be able to respond to climate change and sea level rise on its own. Secondly, one solution here in Georgia is the development of living shorelines. And living shorelines are kind of a bioengineering approach where we use grass planting and also oyster reef construction to stabilize the shoreline.
Living shorelines are a natural way to decrease erosion along our coastline, along tidal creeks, where areas erode. We developed these nature-based engineering solutions. This helps us to avoid hardened shorelines, such as bulkheads and seawalls, And those bulkheads and walls, when we place those along the shoreline, they can actually increase erosion along the coast. Because the energy comes in and it hits a hard surface. And then the energy erodes along the shoreline, the base of the shoreline and the top of the shoreline. By using nature-based solutions and living shorelines, we can decrease the erosion to the coast and provide habitat. We're so fortunate to have marshes that thrive, and marshes are healthy, and we haven't destroyed our marshes in Georgia. We have the opportunity and the responsibility to take care of our salt marshes. And we have strong partners and communities along the Georgia coast. And by all working together and doing our part, I really believe that we can protect and take care of our marshes for today and also for the future.